Hello guys, DJ Pazin here, another game of Through the Ages. I already started the game. It's a 3-player game again, with the random mix, and we have Thallium, ChrisTheBest, and me, and we're gonna go into the game. Got the Super Blitz again, and Thallium decides to go offline right off the bat, without doing his first move. But we can still have a look at the cards. So, Library and Hammurabi, very good. Engineering Genius here as well. And we have three Civil Actions, of course. And there's quite a lot of good cards in the first and second row. Library, Hammurabi, Urban Growth, and Engineering Genius. Colosseum maybe as well. So, green, I would pick Library if I was green. And then red would probably take Hammurabi and Urban Growth, which would leave me in a little bit of an awkward spot. I would take Engineering Genius, and then could take Stockpile or Frugality. And green decides to come back online. Let's see if he can do his turn real fast. And see if all turns out as I predicted. Also, maybe you have noticed I have a new microphone, and I hope it sounds better now. Before I only had my gaming headset microphone, so this should be a lot better. If you have any comments on this, please let me know. I'm not so experienced with microphones, so if I should change some settings, let me know. And really interesting, they didn't pick at all like I predicted. Green took Stockpile, so I can take Urban Growth, Hammurabi, and Library, which I think are the three best cards, maybe besides Engineering Genius. So I'm really surprised I got such good cards for my three actions. I don't know why green would take Stockpile. Maybe he wants new leaders and wonders. Maybe he doesn't like Hammurabi and the library anymore. Red, of course, taking Engineering Genius isn't bad, but if I was red, I would definitely have taken Library and Hammurabi. It's better than just Engineering Genius. And we can also take a look what is in the game. Interesting, there's Sun Tzu and Yanzitska. This is super strong combo, so I would like if nobody took Sun Tzu. Let's see what red does. He takes Stonehenge. Okay, there's Engineering Genius 1. Maybe I can take that. And play Hammurabi. And I can go for the HA lab. And then I think I'm gonna take Engineering Genius. This means I can't finish this next turn, so maybe I'd rather play Bronze Mine instead of this. Like this, I can finish the library next turn, which I like more than... Usually it's better to go for the lab, but in this situation I need the resources next turn more than I need the one science. And then I can finish the library and get my science from here faster. So I think this is worth it. Let's see which leader green wants to take. And there's still Sun Tzu and Hippocrates. Each of one can take one. Also green doesn't have wonder yet, and very early universitas is really strong. Let's see, there's Pierre de Coubertin and Marlene Dietrich. So drama and Dragon Circuses become stronger. There's also an early monarchy, which I would really like to pick up. Can we see development of warfare, science and religion. We don't have one worker free, so we're gonna take science, which also isn't too bad, gaining two science. It's really valuable in the beginning. And we would really like to pick up Monarchy, But I don't think I would pick it up for 3, because that would mean I can't finish my library. For 2, maybe I would. Maybe I would pick it up for 2. Red will can't finish his Stonehenge. He also probably wants to take Sun Tzu. Not having an HLA leader can be really bad, especially if there's Sun Tzu, who's pretty strong in my opinion. Could also immediately go for Isabella. Like an early H1 leader can also be good, but yeah, he takes Sun Tzu. And builds on his Wunder, so Monarchy stays at 3, so I'm not gonna pick it up. I also don't want to play Politics necessarily. Development of Science, and then I can finish my library. And I could also take the universities. Interesting. I could definitely do that. But there's also a magic castle which is pretty strong. Other than that, not that great wonders. So maybe I take universities this early. Can be really good. And then I'm gonna do it. And of course, this means I need quite a lot of resources. So I definitely want to spend my civil actions on science, like monarchy or code of laws. Can also mean that I have a turn where I don't have a lot to do, where I would like to do in the revolution. So if I can take monarchy next turn, that would be really great. But I guess red could really use it as well. He can build one step of Stonehenge. Yeah, Pact Offer, this is a really nice pact. We can use food as resources. We need quite a lot of resources for our early second wonder. We have quite a lot of food right now. Also, I don't need to build any philosophies because of my two wonders. So I don't need the population, so this is a really great deal for us. Okay, he takes Ivan and Urban Growth. So yeah, I'm interested to see if Red will go for the play that I would do, which is building one step of Stonehenge, or even finishing it, and then taking Monarchy and developing it immediately, which would be really good, which would also mean I don't get Monarchy. Then I maybe have to take Code of Laws to spend my civil actions. Can also increase my population twice, build one step. I don't think I have to be careful actually. Okay, he rejected the pact. It was the, I can see it here, the Pact of Open Borders Agreement, which I also think I wouldn't have accepted. One extra military action is really nice, but against Red, who also took the two warriors, or the free warrior from the development of warfare, instead of development of religion or science. So he has quite a lot of strength, and if you agree to open borders, it would make it very dangerous. Also, he draws so many cards so that he could easily draw a good tactic and an aggression, so yeah, I wouldn't have accepted either. I have to see what I spent my urban growth on. I really don't think that I want another philosophy. Once I finished my universitas, I'm at 4 science production this early, so I don't need to spend anything on the lab. Okay, he decides not to go for the monarchy. Also, we luckily have one of these cards, so we can defend if he tries an aggression on us. So yeah, I'm gonna develop, increase my population twice. Maybe Before I do that, I go for Court of Laws. I'm gonna build the universities instead with a pact, so I don't have food consumption, which is nice. Saves me quite a lot. I could increase population once again, but maybe I'll take drama. It's quite expensive, I don't have that many resources because I need to spend it on the wonder. So I also could take reserves. So reserves or drama, there's still another drama. But now I'd rather have reserves, so I can finish my wonder next turn. So let's see which H1 leader we would like. And Genghis Khan, we don't have any tactics for him. And this guy would definitely take him. Sooner or later this tactic will become available. And then Janzitska is pretty good. He's overall really good. Other than that, Joan of Arc is always okay to have. Saladin as well. Yeah, I would probably prefer Janzitska, especially if I can take it away from Red. And I'm gonna guess Red will finish the wonder this turn and then go for Monarchy, which maybe doesn't give him enough actions to take Jan. And Greenwood probably wants to develop his iron and increase his resource production. Also, he hasn't any wonder yet, so yeah, I wondered if he would take the Machu Picchu and place this tactic. I'm generally not a fan of playing tactics just to get it out of your hand, because you make them available for your opponents. So I just made Genghis Khan way better for both of us, because Genghis Khan is only really good if you have this tactic, and if we didn't draw it, then couldn't take Genghis. Now he definitely is an option, so I might take him. If Red takes Janzitska, then I will take Genghis Khan. I just need to build two warriors, and the turn after I can copy his tactic. And he has 8 resources, so he can't finish the Machu Picchu next turn. And Red finishes his wonder. He doesn't finish it. No, he wants to take stuff instead. Okay, now Janzitska is on 2 and Genghis on 1. So I'm not sure what to do. First I'm gonna finish wonder. Genghis Khan can be really good. And I guess I'm gonna take him. Then I don't have the resource for this. I'm gonna also just take him and take Swordsman as well, which I think I'm gonna do like this. I don't have to replace him away, he's always good, so I can keep him a little bit longer. And the next turn I can go for Swordsman. To see, maybe I can even pick up a Magic Castle, but probably Red will take that. But I still can go for Genghis, go for Swordsman, build one Swordsman. I don't have any military actions to copy his tactic, but I also not in a hurry to get this tactic. Another nice point is if I'm gonna go for the heavy cavalry with Genghis. Okay, interesting. He goes for quite a lot of military. So I definitely want to build swordsman next turn. We also have like bread and circuses. But they're gone. And I still have to use my urban growth, maybe just for one religion. Okay, place an aggression. Luckily we can defend. So I really have to go for military. Sadly I can only build one swordsman, but it will put me at 3. And then I can defend. For now at least. He can also take Janitska now. And with him fulfill his tactic once more. This tactic will be 2 strength, so red can take can go for quite a lot of strength as well. So maybe I should have taken Janitska, I'm not sure right now. Right now I'm struggling a bit to keep up with military. But once Genghis is going with heavy cavalry, then it shouldn't be the biggest problem. I'd also probably like theocracy, but not for 3. Maybe it comes now and next turn I can take it. And with my code of laws, I'm fine with staying at 5 civil actions. If it can give me my third military action and some strength as well. So red could take Magic Castle. But I don't think he has the... Okay, he does. Okay, just up to 6. So maybe now I play politics. I think I do. Because I want a little bit more... would be really nice to gain 2 resources. Which isn't too unlikely. And I'm gonna play... Rebellion, probably. Gain 2 resources, this is really nice. So I can develop swordsmen and build 2 swordsmen. And no, I don't replace. I could 11 cards. Yeah, I probably should replace him. Also gains me 3 culture. And then I can take breakthrough and reserves maybe. Now I didn't use my urban growth, but it's only from HA and it isn't a big deal. There's also bread and circuses, would probably pick that up, as well as bureaucracy. And next turn I can copy this tactic and gain 4 strength. And green will probably build 1 knight as well. So I'm not sure which leader red wants to pick up. He didn't want Janitska. Also I hope that he stays at this tactic, the fighting band. And because I can copy that after I lose Genghis Khan and still have a nice tactic. Green still has to build on his Machu Picchu. You really need to finish it quite early for it to be worth it. So with 5 resources he can't even finish it next turn, but he's at 12th rank now. So very heavy military game right now. I'm gonna probably take theocracy. And if I can also take bread and circuses, that would be really nice because I could go for both with breakthrough and still use my urban growth. I also have to concern myself with food production, but no one has a any food production upgraded yet. So I could take irrigation or wait for selective breeding. So like the game turned out, I would prefer to have Jan Zitzka now instead of Genghis Khan. I didn't think that green would go for the less heavy investment into military, which will make it quite hard for me to keep up with military, and Jan Zitzka would have been better in that situation. I mean, I can now copy the tactic and still have quite a lot of military. But Genghis Khan is really the strongest when you don't have to invest too much, because at some point he doesn't give you all that much strength. And if he doesn't produce his three culture, then it's only meh. Edward also has the Magic Castle, he can gain some strength from that, but the good thing is that I'm at 4 science production and both of them are only at 2, which is really cool. Allows me to go for a lot of good attacks. He takes Saladin, okay. I'm gonna skip this. I really want Theocracy and Breton Circuses. Still use my urban growth. And maybe I don't want to use the tactic, the pact. I can upgrade once and copy the tactic. This puts me at 11, which is fine. Oh, I built the wrong building, I see. Happens sometimes if I play too fast. And then copy, yep. So now I'm at 12 even, which is nice. And I have quite a lot of happy faces, and we put the rebellion in, okay. We didn't put the immigration in. And we also produce 3 culture. And green is still at only 4 civil actions, has an happy face problem, needs to finish his wonder as soon as possible, needs to upgrade his food production probably. So I don't think green will go for even more military. And red, yeah, he finishes his wonder next turn and then gains 2 strength. But also he has to use Saladin for the strength bonus, which isn't really ideal. We draw scientific cooperation. I don't think anyone will agree to do that pact with us. So I can play irrigation next turn. With 3 happy faces right now, it's really good. And they are not the greatest leaders. Napoleon is always nice, even though I only have swordsmen right now. And then there is not much else. Maybe Antoni Gaudi. I have 2 different. Could go for another type of urban building. James Cook, I don't have any colonies on the deck. Shakespeare, quite expensive. Maybe James Watt, if the situation is right. So let's see if Red wants to play politics. Rebellion would be really nice. If green lost 2 civil actions, would be really bad for him. So I'm definitely gonna play immigration. And we won't get irrigation. And I can still increase once. Maybe I want to wait with that, but I don't have a lot of other stuff I can do. And also corruption. and wonders are Louvre is really nice, Kremlin with all of our hippie bases can be nice. Transcontinental Railroad is strong, but we don't have iron, so we would need coal. And then Harvard College, I don't think I want another wonder that produces science. Also, I have inhabited territory, so Suez Canal could be okay. But also, it's not like I have so many resources that I really need to take wonder. I definitely have other stuff I can spend my limited resources on. Finishes his wonder, takes breakthrough and irrigation. And wants to go for alchemy. So I will play immigration. Vast territory. I would definitely bid 4. Maybe even 6. And I don't have to concern myself with any food problems. So I guess I would bid up to 6. It's really expensive. But I can rebuild them immediately. And it's still very early, so it's a very good investment, and with 6 I will get it. Not too sure about this. And with the reserves I can rebuild. Like this, and then I can take patriotism and cultural heritage or revolutionary idea, but I guess it's gonna be these two. So that was quite expensive, but I'm okay with it. It's gonna save a lot of food over the long run. It's always not the greatest to build if you have to send away 2 units, because it costs 2 civil actions to increase population, also the food from that, and then 6 resources I have to spend. But getting 3 yellow tokens and 3 food will be really strong over the flow of the game. I would now like some blue technologies, probably my strategy. Strategy would be really good. I have a lot of science I want to get rid of. I also have to consider if I still want to take selective breeding. I don't have to now with my vast territory, but it's still really strong. But maybe I'd rather take coal instead. Also just build another farm from HA, which isn't ideal, but I can also stay like this. This colony also makes Suez Canal even better if I want to go for that, but I would really need the resources for that. And it's not too expensive. I mean, yeah, it's also not cheap. 11. Maybe if I can get Engineering Genius or some more reserves, then I could go for that. I don't know why green isn't playing politics. Maybe he doesn't have any good things in hand. I mean, he's the strongest, so I don't see a real reason why. I mean, of course he has John, so probably rebellion is on top, which would be my guess. which isn't really that important of an information. We knew already that it's in here. And he also doesn't build a new happy face, so... The sad thing is that I only have independence declaration that I could play, and so maybe I have to play inhabited territory, but I definitely want to play politics when I'm still the strongest. Red also doesn't have too many resources and quite a lot of technologies in hand, so he probably wants to upgrade his philosophy. There's James Watt, but I'm also not too sure I want to pick him up. Especially not for free. It's not the leader you pick up for free. Wait for him to come to the front, and then if there's coal also, then you can take him. So if my read was correctly and it's rebellion, then I definitely want, then I definitely have to play politics. So green loses two selections. He loses quite a lot of resources and food now, and he's lacking in. Okay, his plan is probably to lose two selections from rebellion and then go for. Can he actually go for... I'm not sure about the rules. If he can go for a revolution if he has two selections missing. I don't think he can. So next time I definitely can pick up selective breeding, if I want to. It's nice to have. I also have enough science to go for that. What I really want is resources, so maybe I will take Wave of Nationalism. I'm gonna guess at some point I'm gonna be weaker than the others. Not sure why Red is thinking so long. Doesn't have that much stuff. Okay, takes Cavalryman and Maria Theresa. Interesting. And so yeah, as I said, I'm gonna play inhabited territory. And it's historic territory. Okay, so it wasn't the revolution the revolt. The Rebellion, it's called, yeah. I would take it for one, sure. But I'm not gonna bet two for the historic territory. Green takes it, which is nice for green. Also makes him safe from Rebellion. Only has to send away one. So I guess I'm gonna increase my population. I want the cannons. I want Wave of Nationalism. And I would like selective breeding. I'm not sure. I also don't want to build cannons now because then it's gonna be hard to make use of Wave of Nationalism. So maybe instead I'm gonna build a farm, so I don't have corruption like this, maybe. This means I don't have to take selective breeding with a vast territory, and three farms will last me quite a while. So I would like to take Napoleon as my leader, I think. Red has one already, green also, so I can wait for him. Also I would like a tactic where I can use my cannon. But it's, I can also just go back to the fighting band. But with Napoleon, of course, I want to play cannons. Also I have a war in hand. But it's gonna be hard to play a war on red because of this magic castle. So if I do that, it's gonna probably be on green. Who now goes for some sign production. Again, I didn't draw any good green cards that I could play, and I really don't think I want to play Independence Declaration. I mean, I could, if I'm gonna go for Napoleon, it's very likely I won't be the weakest. Next turn I also can go for coal, but maybe only if the fission upgrade isn't taken away. I can develop coal and build one. Also I don't have enough food to increase my population, so I have to upgrade something so I don't have corruption, and coal would be really nice. So yeah, I'm probably gonna go for coal. Also would like Kremlin after that, so I get the 6th civil action, which would be nice. And yeah, the others, I mean the others are fine too, especially if I go for coal I will have a lot of resources which I would like to spend. I mean theoretically I could switch from bureaucracy to constitutional monarchy. I have enough science for that. But I really don't like that. It's not, it's still definitely better, but it's not this huge jump you want to get with changing your government. 12 science is quite a lot, so I'd rather go for coal. And I guess I'm gonna play Independence Declaration. There's very little politics being played, both of these from me. I would really like to get immigration before they upgrade their happy faces. Also, of course, my favorite leader would be Pierre de Coubertin, as it is right now. So I hope I can pick him up in the third age. Yes, used quite a lot of his time, both of them. Not the fastest players. Just hope he doesn't get kicked out. He goes for iron quite late and takes a fission upgrade, so I won't be getting that. And coal still stays on 2, yeah. So I'm gonna play Independence Declaration. Crusades, that's nice for me. And then, as I said, I'm gonna go for coal. Maybe like this. Yeah, I mean I won't need the one fruit next turn, but maybe I should do it this turn. So next turn I'm gonna have 3 fruit, which is enough. So I'm gonna do it like this. And I don't think I want any of these. Journalism is a little bit too expensive. I have Code of Laws already in team spots. I have also, so I'm gonna play Cultural Heritage instead. And so I said before, I would really like strategy. Inhabited territory. Would definitely go for this. Luckily I draw two cards. That's nice. Which also makes me the weakest, so I can use Wave of Nationalism. So that was really nice. And again, I don't have to upgrade my food production anymore this game. The one problem I have is I don't have a good tactic once I replace Genghis Khan. But I still have some time in H2 where I can draw either the defensive army or the fortifications. I could also go for Napoleonic. There's also still the cavalrymen left, and of course in H3 the tanks aren't really contested much, so I definitely would take them as well. Looks like green has, mobile artillery, so I really have to be careful. Sixteen is quite a lot, but once I've rebuilt my swordsman, maybe even one cannon, with patriotism and wave of nationalism, then I should be fine. Also, Napoleon takes quite a while to come, but I really think I should take him. I have quite a lead in culture, so Napoleon will really defend it for me. There's a Kremlin as well, but it's gonna be on three, so I'm not gonna take it. And since we know that it's a rebellion, I can definitely play the politics of strength. And the next card is going to be immigration, where we are have the most as well, which is nice. So I'm going to play the wave of nationalism and patriotism. I can build one here. I'll choose the pact and one cannon. And then I can also upgrade one iron again. So I'm at 15. This seems nice. I can take Napoleon next turn. I still have one turn left in H2, I think, where I can swap them out. Maybe I should take cavalrymen if I can. I don't think green will go for that. So I have 7 production, which is really nice. I have enough food because of my 2 colonies. So this is really good. 4 starts to be not enough, but I think I can manage with just 4 science production. And then culture, I only have 3 production, but I have quite a lead. And once I get Pierre de Coubertin, I can also build some more arenas. And if I can, I would really like to pick up Kremlin as well. And their strategy. So quite a lot of good cards I would like to pick up. Sadly, I don't have all the civil actions. So maybe I don't pick up strategy. There are two military theories in H3. Pact of Yep, I will agree on this. Losing even one more culture. And gives him only basically the strength against green. And I don't want green to be able to play an aggression on red, because that would make green stronger. Red really has to concern himself with military. Just hope that he doesn't play organized religion now and has more happy faces than me. And I could play Crime Wave next turn and then hope that we are still the one with the most happy faces. Also don't really see a reason for Red to go for organized religion now. Should rather go for cavalrymen. Yeah, he does. That's this tactic, okay. And now he is stronger than me, but I know it's gonna be immigration, which is really good. And I can play Crime Wave and even gain one population. And then I have to take Napoleon and replace him. And maybe also cavalrymen. And then I can even copy this tactic. Put me at 25, and I can increase once and take breakthrough as well. So I don't take Kremlin, but I've really found other stuff I'd rather do, like going for cavalrymen, copying the tactic, putting me way ahead of the others, especially considering there's independence declaration and politics of strength. Kremlin would have been nice, but it's not a must-have. Okay, sadly I didn't draw any cards, but I would send away two of my swordsmen. I think three would be too much. Yeah, three would be too much. Because I lose even more strength because of Napoleon, so I would bet four. Because I don't need them for my tactic. And now green takes it with one knight. That's really nice for him, he doesn't have to build any new ways of gaining happy faces now. As both of these territories also gives him quite a lot of culture. But still he's only at 34 and we have 59. I definitely think green is going to be the player to watch out. Don't see red being stronger than green at this moment. Also green now at 16 science and 8 production, which is really quite a lot. Can go for strategy, doesn't have any blue technologies right now, so again go for strategy and navigation if he wants to. Can also go for the Louvre, not yet. Builds a new cannon and takes strategy and goes for the public, so it's also looking quite good for green. So have to be careful. And I think I can also go for a war on red. Spaceflight. Not the greatest so early. I guess I really want another cannon and cavalryman. And with the breakthrough, now an early military theory would be really good again. And I could go for that next turn. Could also go for computers, even though. Yeah, with Marie Curie or Sid Meier, could go for that. Can also go for mechanized agriculture with International Red Cross. So there's a lot of options. I have the resource production to go for a lot of options. I'm lacking in science. But with a breakthrough, I can also maybe take that breakthrough. I think I will be fine. Also, if I go for the war over territory with red, I will gain even more yellow tokens. Could also go for the plunder, but he only has 3 cards. He has a magic castle. But also, if I play an aggression on him, this will end, and he will have even less military. Then also green could take advantage of, but he only has one card in hand. So I guess I'm gonna play the aggression plunder on red. Should be quite unlikely that he can defend. Depending a lot on if he drew a lot of defend cards. And he can't defend, which is really nice. Definitely want some food, maybe 2 food, and the rest resources, so I can increase once again. And then maybe I just go for another pair of these, puts me at 36. Maybe take patriotism. Or reserves instead, maybe patriotism. I don't have that many military actions. I'm gonna take rich land as well, and maybe selective breeding or architecture, maybe architecture like this. Yeah, if I'm gonna go for more food, I think it's gonna be the mechanized agriculture. Also, this really nice. Probably would like to draw War of a Culture, and then I would only need some more turns to go for this army twice, maybe with air forces, and a big war on green or red. Also, I could still go for the modern army if I get the modern infantry. I just need one more infantry to fulfill that tactic twice. Architecture, I have breakthrough, so I definitely can go for that. It's quite. I have to be really careful where I spend my science. Maybe take a revolutionary idea if I can get my hands on that. Also, I have to see if green will take the air forces. But green probably wants to play strategy, so he has more military actions. 2 isn't enough for anything really. Can't use his strength right now, so he goes for this and tanks and open both end movies, okay. Still has a wonder he hasn't finished yet. Goes up to 36, but we are also at 36. Can definitely take military theory. Red is really far too behind in military. Basically, I think he's behind in a lot of things. He wasn't the highest level, so it was a little bit expected. But he couldn't keep up. Yeah, he has, as you can see, 5-3. He's last in actions. And basically last in almost every aspect of the game, especially strength. But it's also really hard to play against two really high level players if you're not that experienced in the game. This game has a really high learning curve, and I think you definitely have to be above level 30 or something to really get a good grasp on the game, and after that you also can still become a lot better. But below level 30, it's really hard to keep up with other players who have played a lot more. So I guess I'm gonna play the war on red and then take military theory. I can also increase my protection a little more with rich land, and then I'm gonna take reserves as well. Yeah, like this. Not the hardest turn, I had very good use of all my actions. We'll gain quite a lot of yellow tokens. Have to see if Red will surrender the game or if he will fight on. Could also take professional sports. That's really good with a lot of impacts. Green has already played one impact now. Maybe science, impact of science or technology, if he has drawn those. It's always hard to guess which ones they play if they don't have a lot in hand. Maybe he just wanted to play anything. So he goes for Chaplain, which is interesting. I would really like Pierre to come sooner than later. Or I have to find another way to produce culture. Could also go for more wars, but I haven't drawn any yet. This revolutionary idea, I would really like that. Player 9 production is really high, but he doesn't produce that much science now. Also, his Louvre Museum is really in his way a little bit. Can't take any new wonders. If you would like to, because he has to finish this first, and it's gonna give him even more culture production, but it's also quite late in the game. And he can finish that next turn. So I have to see how I want to progress with this game. Sadly, I didn't draw any war over cultures, which makes my options not that plentiful. Nelson Mandela could also be worth quite a lot, but I won't have any discontent workers, so it's too expensive to take, especially after the war. Could produce quite a lot with the surplus happy faces once I increase my happy faces. So gain 3 of those. Yeah, I guess I have to play an aggression as well. This could be really nice if I get this aggression through. Destroy this and this, and have enough for the Empire State Building. Culture writing, science writing, food production, I can't really gain anything there. So I guess I'm gonna finish this and gain 16, which is okay. And then I have one action left, I have to spend it on something that I can't really. Maybe just play reserves for food. Losing 2 resources isn't too bad, I have a very high collection. So maybe I do it like this. Again, no war over culture. And this is also not too good for us. So I have to see. Maybe next turn I play the aggression infiltrate on red. Gains me some culture. Okay, would definitely want to take this. Could definitely bid 7. I don't want to send my last swordsman, I would have to rebuild it. Okay, red takes it. With his navigation. His politics of strength next. Maybe I can draw some wars from there. So yeah, the 16 from this was pretty nice. This can be really a lot more, but in a 3-player game it's hard to be in front in more than 2. 3 could definitely happen. We had strength and resource production. Culture and science was a little bit close. He has 6. And food, they both, he's at 5 actually with Machu Picchu. So yeah, that was. Also, I didn't want to play around that. Gaining 16 culture from 17 resources is really good for the end. Especially because I have very high resource production. So I guess I definitely can go for the impact of population because I can increase twice. And then I have more than green. See if green finishes his Louvre Museum. He also doesn't have too many actions, but he could take Hollywood as well, I think. 8 maybe not. He has to play reserves. Finish this, that's 4 actions. Yeah, then he also could take Hollywood. See if he wants to do that. Now he goes for computers. And he also has 2 impacts. These impacts could really be trouble for me if they have something to do with science or science production. There's Pierre de Coubertin. Definitely think I would still go for him, at least take him. Also, his one time ape culture is really nice. Next turn, I guess I'm gonna play Impact of Population to maybe draw a war instead of playing the aggression. Red has to rebuild his organized religion now. Also, we have. Yeah, he's slowly catching up. 60 to 84, but we have one turn more. So I think I'm still fine. Could be really close with these impacts. But again, I still can draw a war and gain quite a lot of culture from there. Question would be if I would play it on green or red. Depending on a little bit on what I can do else. I mean, I can just build 2 more cannons and go for this tactic. This one, the mechanized army, that would give me quite a lot. But I will also probably lose Napoleon before I can go through with the war. So I have to see if I have enough to go for war against Queen. So I'm gonna play the Impact of Population. And there's a war. So I guess I'm gonna take Pierre and then go for this. At 57. And I can declare war on red next turn. I guess I'm also gonna take Revolutionary Idea. Yeah. And throw away some of these ruler cards. I'm also not gonna need another tactic, so like this. Hook of Industry can also be quite good. And some more impacts even. This isn't too good. Harmony also nope. But Strength, especially because I'm the last player. So I can see if I have enough, which I really should. ...90 to 60, 30 points. He also has to build on his wonder before I could take this. So I definitely could take this, 16. Could finish that. Crime wave. Nice, them even losing some culture. And this is the last wonder, so maybe I would take that. You know, well, I can't really, because it's too expensive. I also have to swap Pierre Coubertin for Napoleon. But green doesn't take air forces, and I can take them and even build one. green also has quite a lot of resources, so you can also take air forces and build them next turn. So you probably will take them to keep open as options. No, he doesn't, okay. But he makes himself ready to copy my tactic. But I would like to end the game pretty soon. Terrorism, okay, that's good for him, but not expensive for us. It's actually good for us, he can destroy the movies from green, which will be really expensive for green to rebuild. And this movies produces some 8 culture. So that was really nice. So yeah, I would like to end the game after my turn, or the age, so green doesn't have the chance to go for a war if he wants to. And also I don't want to give him too many turns to keep to catch up to me. So I would like to play a war on red and then finish the age. Then I also have to play Pierre, which will cost me a little bit of strength from Napoleon. So one air force should be fine. If I get one air force as well, then I really should have been enough for the war against the red. And honestly, I also could go against the war for a war against green. Build 2 air forces. I mean, he has quite a lot of resources, but he doesn't have air forces. He can copy my tactic, which would give him 10, and then maybe fill it once more with 2 additional cannons. But if I get 2 air forces, that's 30 strength. So maybe we'll do that. Yeah, especially with the military build-up, I think it's better to go for a war against green now. And then take air forces. I have to rebuild here once. Oh, then I don't have enough resources. So I guess I'm gonna destroy this. Quite nice. But I lose some because I have to play here, and then I will also delete one of these. Yeah, this seems really good. Don't end the age, but that's not too bad. And I don't need this. This is even worse. So I'm gonna look at this. 80, so we can't really catch up. You really should have taken the Air Force away from me. Instead of urban growth and engineering, he took something from the second, from 2 selections. He should have taken the air forces away from me. A bit of technology, okay, 12, 8 and 4, 8 also, okay. So not too bad. And then next turn. Maybe I can play an aggression. Bit of progress shouldn't be... Yeah, it's not too bad for us. Sadly, I'm gonna lose architecture before I can develop that. Could play an aggression on green. And also, he lost his movies to terrorism. So, the last turn wasn't good for green. We probably imagined those turns differently. He probably has to go for two cannons now. So, you can definitely go for some additional strength, but it's not gonna be enough. Also, I don't have any urban buildings. Very typical strength game. From early on, even. In the beginning, with him having heavy cavalry, me having Genghis Khan. So, 52. Doesn't go for. Even more cannons, but decides to rebuild his theater instead. And red had, I think most of his problems came from his leaders. Maria Theresa isn't really good. And then he struggled with military as well. Also can use Pierre de Coubertin's special ability to gain 8 culture, but then I can't play the aggression, so maybe I wait with that one turn. I still have 2 turns left, so I have time. So I'm probably gonna play the aggression next turn. And after that, play the Impet of Strength. So I'm going to go for fundamentalism, goes for more military. Okay. So yeah, gain 33 strength. Do not declare them. Play an aggression on red. On green. And then I have to rebuild some of these. Again, destroy this one as well. That gives me quite a lot of culture. This looks nice. And then I guess I can take something to develop, but Impact of Technology has already been played. So I don't really know. I would have taken Civil Service, but maybe take just efficient upgrade and oil. So they don't have as many options what they would like to take. Throw away these. So yeah, 150 against 61 and 60, and this is pretty clear. Now it's going to be interesting to see who will be second. My guess would be green because of his impacts that he played. But I'm also going to play Impact of Strength, which will Right now would be better for red. But green just has way more stuff for the impacts, really. Population 14. Only 6 from him and 14 from me as well. So yeah, my guess is still on green. And I can use Pierre de Coubertin 8 culture next turn and then play Invader of Strength. That's my plan. I think green's problem was mostly from his wonders. Machu Picchu took him very long to build, especially after he went for the 3 knights that he had to build. If he had invested that instead of into Machu Picchu, had gotten that earlier, it maybe would have paid off more. And then the Louvre Museum, which he had for quite a while, but didn't build on it. Which isn't necessarily a mistake, you can definitely take it and then not build on it, but it felt a little bit like it was blocking him from taking H3 wonders, and he had to build this at some point, and then he only had like 3 or 4 turns with it, and then it's not worth it. Especially because he had to use the resources from that. I think the turn after he finished it, so it didn't produce him really that much culture. So I was really happy with my wonder choice, taking library and universitas. I didn't have to build any labs, I actually destroyed mine, and I was fine with my science. So these are a really good combo. Can save you quite a lot of actions where you don't have to build labs and resources and science if you want to upgrade those. I'm still a little bit weirded out by the first turn where green took stockpile. I think there was the first foundation of my win, getting Hammurabi and Library of Alexandria and Urban Growth for my first turn, which is almost the perfect combo. Here goes for food, so that's probably impact of agriculture. Keep that in mind. Red even with one unhappy face and negative food production. Bad food, so you won't have starving population. So 90 is his score, 66, and he won't get too much. So yeah, fought bravely, actually got close because of my war against green. So overall not too bad. Maybe had to, maybe not take Maria Theresa, and he lost two. He didn't have enough strength in the H2. Okay, final turn, declare Olympic Games. And play in better strength. Government, there we don't have that much. Need 2, 13, and 16. Can play Revolutionary Idea, can build oil. But this oil doesn't matter. Can actually delete these and with food for the food impact, and I can upgrade because why not, and end the turn. And now the impacts, a bit of wonders, we also have quite a lot of wonders, The strength 1407, it might get close, but not really. The agriculture, he only has 2, yeah. Variety 12, 16, and 12. Culture, yeah, so it wasn't close between those two. And so between me and green, also not really close. So, very unclose game, I would say. But still, in the middle of the game was really interesting. And the early game as well was a very aggressive early game. I enjoyed this game, I hope you did as well. And as always, hope to see you next time. Leave me a comment, subscribe if you haven't already. And until next time, see you then.